Previously on Game of Thrones.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. He knows all your weaknesses, all your plans, because you have a traitor in your council. He's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing.
We were told we'd be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone.
That's enough, Andros.
Northgrove? That's just some shit story for little kids.
I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about. I'm part of the free folk. People round here call wildlings.
My true name is Sarah. Flowers.
You're a bastard?
It means a lot to be able to share that with someone. Someone I can trust.
And if it isn't Elena Glenmore, you're not still marrying into this wretched family.
I'm sorry. I'm going to tell Father the betrothal is off.
It's a long journey to Meereen on foot.
Meereen? Shit.
What?
Unfinished business there. I don't want to talk about it.
If you presume to speak of my dragons, you best choose your words carefully.
Malcolm!
Are you gonna be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down? You can be Lord Roderick. So long as we all know who holds the reins here.
The foresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward. Kill him if they give you any trouble.
I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig.
I knew you were a killer the day you arrived. Seems Britt found out too. Now they all see it.
It wasn't my fault. He attacked me and we fought and...
So you struck him down and left him to die. You told me what you did to get here. We both know you had blood on your hands. But now you've killed one of your brothers. You'll lose your head for this, Tuttle. You'll be disgraced, dishonored, and burned till there's nothing left of you.
I swear by all the gods, old and new, this was an accident. I didn't mean for him to die.
Didn't mean it. Murder's in your blood. There's only one thing to be done with you now.
Hey, Frostfinger. I saw what Garrett did to Britt last night. I was there. My relief was late, so I stayed behind. I saw everything. Finn was only there at the very end.
You had your say.
Actually, I was there the whole time.
Oh. Then tell us.
Garrett's telling the truth. Britt attacked him. Just like he said, Garrett had no choice but to fight back.
There isn't a man at the wall wouldn't sell his own mother for the right price. You two are up to something. some deal you worked out. Or he's defending you for some reason I can't fathom.
That's impossible. Finn can't stand me. Because you're a fucking squire who thinks you're better than everyone.
Enough! Garrett killed a man of the watch. There's a price to be paid for that. Let's go. I knew it was a mistake to make you a ranger.
Rosfinger. What's to be done with him? We're heading to Craster's.
You'll have to find someone else for your expedition. Your man here still has a lot to answer for. Now out of the way, Snow.
Give us a moment.
Then kiss him quick and be done with it.
Garrett. You told me there wouldn't be any trouble with Brit.
What happened?
I thought you were smarter than that, Garrett.
I thought you were going to be by my side at Craster's. But there's no coming back from this.
This isn't right. Brit's the murderer. Frostfinger has this all wrong.
What Brit did to your family. Anyone would want him dead.
But John...
Is there nothing to be done?
Aside from removing Tuttle's head from his shoulders? No.
But...
You're about to go off and execute a nest full of traitors at Craster's. How is this any different?
Gods be with you, Garrett. We're down a man, so keep your eyes open. Now let's move.
You can go begging to your gods all you want, boy. It's the Axe has the final say.
Do you know how many men have stood before me with false tales of my dragons? Desperate men, hoping for wealth, protection. Liars, every one of them. And I expect you are no different. You don't want to see what I do to liars.
I wouldn't lie to you. You have my word.
Your word means nothing. Not when it is so easily bought.
Shit.
Are you frightened? I thought you'd seen a dragon before. Your reaction says otherwise.
He's much smaller than the other one.
Would you like to touch him? Go ahead. Unless you are afraid. Of course, a man who has really faced a dragon before may have reason to be afraid. Go on. You're brave, at least.
I don't think he likes me.
You still have a hand, don't you? You claim you saw Drogon. Give me a reason to believe you. I told you I've heard this story before. I'm going to need more than that.
I have this.
Drogon, how did you get that? What have you done to him? If you've hurt him...
Hurt him?
He attacked us.
Drogon wouldn't strike without reason. You must have scared him.
He is not some kind of thoughtless beast. He's only a child.
Oh, a child who can breathe fire on whoever he likes.
If we did, I'm sorry. It wasn't our intention. We weren't looking for a fight.
And neither was he.
Sure he wasn't. Your tongue is dangerously sharp, sellsword. Why did you come here?
You've been polite, accommodating.
To what end? You want gold? A title? My undying gratitude?
My little brother was murdered in front of his family, and our youngest is still held against his will at our enemy's house.
What is it you expect me to do?
We need to hire an army.
An army?
If you could spare some of your sellswords.
Please, if...
I also came here looking for an army. But what I found were the cries of children and people suffering in chains while their masters profited from their misery.
My sellswords will help me free the slaves of Meereen. That is their mission. Your need is not greater than theirs.
These are people who have suffered for years without end.
What if we left after the liberation, once the slaves are free?
Once the slaves are free, I will sail back to Westeros and reclaim my crown.
There is no after.
There must be something I can do to convince you.
As we speak, my men prepare to enter Meereen.
What they are about to do is much bigger than you or I. Bigger than one family back in Westeros. So, unless you think you can storm Meereen and free all the slaves yourself...
You have nothing more to offer me, Croft. You may leave.
That's it.
Your Grace.
See them out.
We're not just sellswords. We're the best damn sellswords in Slaver's Bay.
I know a few who might disagree with you.
His boasting aside, they were two of my best fighters.
And Beskar here, she has a history in Meereen. She could help guide us.
What the hell?
Is this true?
Yes. I lived in Meereen for a time. On the eastern side of the city. Fucking bastard.
So you wish to accompany them? You'd help the Second Sons? Guide them into Meereen?
I can't, Asha.
This could be our only chance.
Is that what you're saying?
You're really considering this?
I can only speak for myself. I'll go alone.
She's the one who knows the city. She will accompany you, or you won't be going at all.
I believe that's more than fair. You two will join Croft and his men. Get them into the city, help them liberate Meereen, and I will see that you are rewarded. But your uncle stays here. If I find you've lied or put my men in danger...
I understand.
Good. Croft will get you settled in. It's going to be a long night.
Are we really going into Meereen?
What's the problem with you and Meereen anyway?
Doesn't matter now, does it?
Beskar.
Get your armor patched up in here. Extra bedrolls if you need them. Piss buckets in the corner where it's always fucking been.
Oh.
Long time since we had a piss bucket.
I spent 2 years trying to get where I am now. Don't fuck this up for me, Asher. Nail! We got two more.
It's not your leg that's the problem, Roderick. You've got to be practical.
You want to take Griff down next time? You want to stop lying in the mud and letting people walk all over you?
You're speaking to your lord, Sir Roylan.
He can fight his own battles.
Next time I face Griff, it will be the last. I won't let him parade around my halls any longer.
I look forward to it, my lord. But you won't win a fair fight.
You can't handle a sword like you used to. So find another advantage. Surprise your opponent. Do something unexpected.
Like what?
I'll show you. Come at me.
Bring your opponent down to your level.
When I attack you, drop down, avoid my blade, and swing at the back of my knees. Wait for me to attack.
Let's try it again.
Now that's how you do it.
I think you let me. Oh!
My lord, sorry to interrupt.
Elena?
She insisted on seeing you immediately.
Lady Elena, I'm sorry to hear we won't be sisters.
Talia. Roderick, can I speak with you? Privately. You remember my little brother?
Quiver! Good gods, you've grown.
You could just call me Arthur now.
I hope you don't mind us coming unannounced. But something's happened. I didn't know what else to do.
I've missed you, Elena.
I've missed you too. Truth be told, you're the only one I can turn to. Lord Whitehill paid my father a visit at Rillwater Crossing. He told my father Griff had subdued you, and...
And that my sister would make a fine reward.
As if I'm some token to be handed around.
You mean...
He demanded I marry his son, Griff.
What?
Lud threatened my family. Told my father if he refused, we'd be slaughtered along with you.
Father acted the damn coward.
He agreed, Roderick. I am to marry Griff Whitehill. That arrogant, pig-eyed prick!
Then you have to defy your father.
I intend to. Do you think I want to marry that disgusting pig? But my father won't listen. I'm not gonna be the bone they throw that howling dog. I'm not gonna be some prize for him to rip open. We have to get rid of him. I can't think of any other way. My father won't see reason.
It's time someone brought Griff down.
We were hoping you'd say that.
You brought your men.
I command Father's elite guard. These men are trained archers, swordsmen, experts in both ranged and close combat. They're yours, if you'll help us take down Griff.
The whole guard?
20 men. My father still thinks they're aboard a ship bound for the Reach. What do you have to lose, Roderick? Griff has been a nightmare for you and your house.
You can't have any reason to keep him around.
Whitey'll still have my little brother. If I hurt Griff, there's no telling what they'll do to Ryan.
I understand your worry, Roderick. I don't want Ryan hurt any more than you do. I know this might sound mad, but it's the only way. Get rid of Griff, and you'll be free to use the guard however you like. You can finally take control of your house again. Please, promise me you'll do this. I love you, Roderick. I don't want Griff. I don't want any of this.
I'll do it, if it really is the only way.
I'm afraid it is. Thank you, Roderick.
I knew you'd come through for us. My men are yours to command.
Thank you, Quip. Arthur.
Could you give us a moment? You don't know how much this means to me. I'm sorry I couldn't marry you before. Maybe when this is all over, we could play hide-and-seek in the Grove again. Pretend we're still children. Forget all that's happened these last few years.
I love you, Helena.
I love you too.
I can't believe it's another coronation already. Our kings just get younger and younger.
Tommen's not ready. He's too soft.
Maybe that was the imp's plan.
I wonder if Marjorie Tyrell will be there today.
You mean Queen Marjorie? She was married to Joffrey.
For all
I
of 1 hour.
Marry his brother too. Not to mention Cersei and Jaime.
Shh.
The Lannisters have spies everywhere.
What is it, Tom?
Remember that warning you'd heard from Roderick?
About Whitehill's contact. Did you find anything?
Only whispers. But your brother's right. Lord Whitehill. Lord Whitehill is sending a great deal of gold to someone here in King's Landing. He's definitely up to something. Something big.
Well done, Tom. Did you hear anything else?
Lord Whitehill is surprisingly secretive. The only people I'm even certain he deals with are those Ironwood merchants. They'll both be at the feast after Tommen's coronation today. Maybe you can learn something.
I can't go. Marjorie's... she's not exactly happy with me right now. I've been uninvited.
Couldn't Sarah help? Ask her to get you in. She'd do it, right? Don't handmaidens look out for each other?
We are friends. I'm sure she'd help if I asked her.
It's a good plan, then.
It's nearly time.
Just be careful, Lady Mira. King's Landing seems to have it in for you.
What are you doing out here? There's leftover honey cake in the kitchens.
Have to guard this one. Locked him up in the old storeroom until morning.
That the one who killed Brit? He's not going anywhere. Come on. He'll be back before anyone notices.
All right. Maybe just a quick bite. He's likely to freeze to death out here anyway. the wood's rotten. This is all bloody useless. Oh, I'm not getting out that way. Must be the latrine. I'm not sticking around to use it. Just sand. Probably covered with fleas. Onions and crab apples. At least I won't starve to death. If I ever find a way out of here. No one out there. Don't know what I expected. Oh, this one looks loose.
Cotter, what are you doing here?
I heard him talking. You're to be executed in the morning.
What about Finn? He told
them. Nobody believes him, or don't want to. They think he's covering for you. Some are even saying he helped you do it.
I have to get out of here.
That's why I came. I want to help.
You'd be executed too. Why would you want to help me?
I told you my secret. And you said you were my friend. Oh, what kind of friend would I be if I left you to die here? So I'm getting you out of here. I don't want to hear any complaining.
I'm not sure I believe you.
What?
Why are you really doing this?
I wasn't lying, Garrett. Well, there is another reason. I want to go with you to the North Grove. You know I can't stay here. I'm leaving Castle Black, but I'd rather not go it alone. So if you're going north, I'm coming with you.
Well, I'm not going anywhere unless I can get out of this bloody storeroom first.
I can try and pick the lock, but I'm not sure it will work. It's rusted a bit inside. I can try, but it may not do any good.
There's a loose stone over here. Can you see it?
Yeah. Yeah. It's not moving, though.
Keep trying. Let me see what I can do.
I can't move it. Won't budge. This might help. Might be useful.
Garrett, what are you doing?
Getting out of here.
I can see it. It's coming loose.
I'm gonna try to push it out. You pull, all right?
I hope no one heard that. Hey, can you fit through?
I think.
You two idiots, lucky I'm not Frostfinger. Thought you were being sly, eh? I figured you'd try something like this.
Finn, you bastard. What are you doing here?
I'm the sword in the darkness. Helping a fellow brother keep his head. You'll need this. Now, let's go.
You're not coming with us, Finn.
What are you on about? Frostfinger already thinks I'm helping you. What do you think he's gonna do when he hears you've run off with Potato Fucker over here? I'd rather take my chances with you. And I'm good in a fight. You know that.
Yeah, good at starting them anyway.
You'll need another blade at your side.
Having another ranger along couldn't hurt.
Till he stabs you in the back.
We'll talk later. Move!
There's no turning back now. We're deserters for sure. We're breaking our vows.
I've taken plenty of oaths. Broken plenty too. Words don't mean shit.
There'll be a price on our heads.
My family back home is counting on me to put things right. And I mean to do it. Vows aren't going to stop me.
They know we're gone now.
Then how fast can you run?
Worse than I thought, isn't it?
Roderick! There you are. Lady Forrester!
What's wrong, Mother?
It's Griff. He was arguing with the Maester and things got out of hand.
I'm coming.
What do you mean to do?
This could be our chance.
He's right. We must hurry before things get violent.
I'll make sure the Maester is safe. That's what matters.
Just don't forget your promise, Roderick.
The rest of my men are still in the grove. They could be here in minutes.
I'll need every one of them for what I'm about to do.
I'll have them here as soon as possible. Let's go.
And Arthur. Listen for my signal. I'll strike my cane when I want you to enter.
We'll be ready.
I'm coming with you.
It's not safe. You should wait for your brother.
I don't care if it isn't safe. Griff thinks I belong to him. I need to show him I don't.
Together, then.
My lord, please.
I am the only lord who matters here. Roderick!
Help me.
Tell your dog to obey his new master. And while you're at it, Elaine at Glenmore? What are you doing with him? You're supposed to be marrying
you
me!
You! I'd rather marry a dead horse.
You watch your bloody tongue, or I'll give you what I'm giving the Maester.
Excuse me?
Let the Maester go, Griff.
Not until he's learned his lesson. He's disobedient, just like you were, Roderick. Before I brought you to heel. So now he's paying the price.
Oh, my hand!
Don't believe you.
You're not the Lord here, Griff. And I'm tired of you pretending you are.
You think I'm fucking pretending? You know what I think?
My brother is ready.
I think you need another lesson in humility. Just like your maester here.
You can watch if you like.
Actually, I think it's your turn.
I don't think so, Roderick! God! Fucking! You're dead, Roderick!
I doubt that.
Grab him! Don't just stand there! He is not the... What the hell is this?
What are your orders?
I'm the only one here who gives the orders! What are you waiting for?
Help the Maester!
Thank you, my lord.
What are you doing? Back away.
Now.
This is my hall! You have no right to be here!
Now then, about humility...
Get your hands off me! My father will go straight to Roose Bolton. He'll flay you and your sister and your whole fucking family!
Leave Ironwrath. Take your soldiers and get out. Then maybe I'll show you mercy.
I'm not going anywhere.
You gonna hurt me? Your friends won't be around forever, Roderick. And when they're gone, I will see that you pay for this! All of you! What's it gonna be, Roderick?
I'm not like you, Griff.
You're right. You are a fucking coward.
Confine the Whitehills to the cellars.
No one gets in or out.
Coward! Bloody coward!
Word cannot reach High Point. You must be sure of it. Not as long as they still hold Ryan. Kill the Ravens. All of them.
I swear I will!
Fuck you and your queen!
That's enough! So long as you're in my camp, you will obey my orders. And getting pissed drunk before a mission...
Obey?
You know what kind of shit-brained fool does that? One who wants to fucking die out there! Have you lost your damn mind?
I am not some animal in a cage!
What in the seven bloody hells are you talking about?
I will not let
about?
You bark orders at me!
Hey, calm down! Calm down! What's going on here?
I'm not the one with the problem. It's him.
She can't fight like this, Asher.
You think I'm too drunk to fight? What the fuck
do
you
know?
What
are you gonna do? Run out there swinging a fucking...
Still think I can't fight?
You fucking bitch!
Oh, there we go.
Hey, come on, Beskar. Leave the poor man alone.
Let go of me before I break your fingers.
Deal with your friend. She'll get us all killed.
You sound scared, Croft.
This is bloody important.
You afraid your mother will spank you?
I will not let you two fuck this up.
Are you looking forward to it?
I'll talk to her.
Good. If she can't hold it together, We're leaving without the both of you.
You think your little thumbcock can take Marine all by itself? I'd never work with a bloody shoat like you
Beska,
anyway!
What the hell is going on?
You gonna lecture me too? Croft doesn't know shit about anything. None of you do.
Will you stop trying to hit me? Whatever your problem is with Croft, just let it go.
You think this is about Croft? You think I give two shits about what Croft has to say? Your fucking uncle is the only reason I'm even here. He told your little dragon queen I would go into Marine with you. You brought me here.
Just talk to me, Beska.
We're done talking. Come on, Asher. Hit me. Oh, if this was a real fight, you'd be dead.
I'm not going to do that. What are you so afraid of?
I was a slave. Here, in this fucking city. I was taken from my home when I was only 3 years old. When I was 7, my master threw me in the fighting pits to die. When my master tired of watching me kill animals for sport, he started sending other children. I butchered every one of them. After a while, I thought the fear was gone. I thought I was used to it.
Lads, what kind of a monster would do that to a child?
To him, we were not children. We were his playthings. His entertainment. There was this boy. We used to play five stones in the alley when we couldn't sleep. When I saw him next, he was in that pit with me. I saw the fear in his eyes. That same fear I felt my first time. And I realized it hadn't left me. I still wanted to live. I wanted it so badly. My master watched as I did it, smiling. I could have killed him for that fucking smile.
That's enough drinking for tonight. It'll only make you feel worse.
I don't need any more men telling me what to do. I bought my freedom a long time ago, but I have always hated this place. Hated him. Dezor Zoraza. Because of that man. Marine is a city of dead children. Don't worry about me. I won't let you down.
Come on. You've had enough. Let me take that.
Why not?
Mira, I'll meet you inside. What are you doing here?
I have to get in there, Sarah. I know I'm not supposed to attend, but...
Then you know Lady Marjorie doesn't want to see you. What could be so important?
Lord Whitehill is up to something. He's conspiring against my family. And someone in there is helping him.
Lady Marjorie would be furious, Mira. I can't. I'm sorry. I want to help you.
I'll take the blame. You can tell Marjorie I snuck in and you tried to stop me.
She's already thinking about replacing you.
Are you sure you want to risk it?
I have to.
All right. You owe me for this. She's with me. We'll stay out of trouble. I promise. Feels a bit strange to celebrate, doesn't it? Not so long ago, King Joffrey sat on the Iron Throne.
Tommen is our king now.
Long may he reign.
Sarah! I was worried you'd run off with your friend there.
And what if I did?
I'm not sure I could blame you.
This is Lady Mira Forrester. Mira, Lord Garibald Tarwick.
She's quite lovely. Where have you been hiding her?
You're making her blush.
You flatter me. Sarah's lovelier than us all.
I won't argue there. It's quite a feast, isn't it? Just be careful around the wine. Though I hear you don't partake yourself. It's easy to forget. Nothing you do in King's Landing goes unnoticed. Drink too much once and you're forever the drunken fool. Talk to the wrong people and...
Oh, Lord Tarwick!
What was that about?
Nothing. That subject isn't fit for your delicate ears anyway.
My ears are not delicate.
Of course they are. Look how tiny they are. Little loads.
Stop it.
What?
I mean it. Someone caught your eye, Mira? My apologies. I just noticed Lords Andros and Morgrin over there.
What a shame. Ruining a perfectly good afternoon with that nonsense.
Perhaps someone should encourage them to argue elsewhere. If you'll excuse me.
This reminds me of the tourney at Lannisport. You wouldn't believe it.
You've told me this story.
But you would have loved it. We danced all evening, drank wine from our helmets.
That is it! Andros, you're being ridiculous!